Hey data people, welcome back to the channel where I take the stress out of Excel and give you the tools you need to beat back that learning curve. Now today I want to jump into Excel Power Query. Don't worry, it's not as scary as it sounds. To get your feet wet, I'm going to show you an easy trick to deal with a common problem found in raw data. And the best news of all is that you can do it in under 2 minutes. That's right. I'm going to teach you how to split a cell into rows using only Power Query. So let's go. Now, an issue I see at least once a week is too much data in one cell. Now, whether it's been downloaded into an ugly looking format or someone decided to use their A1 cell to keep meeting notes.
Why?
Now, back in the day, I used to struggle through and manually separate each cell with some copy and paste. But I promise you, there is a far easier way you can transform your data.
So here we have a simple field of data that on the whole isn't so catastrophic. But look at the last column. We've got several projects listing into one cell. Let's use Excel Power Query to fix this for us by splitting the projects into different rows. The first thing we're going to do is select our entire range of data, then click on the Data tab and select From Table Range. Because this is raw data and not a table, a window pops up asking us to create a table. Make sure the data range in the box is correct, and check or uncheck the option for headers depending on your data. In my case, my data has headers, so I'll leave it checked. Hit OK, and you'll see your data transform into a table and Power Query launch in a separate window. In the Power Query window, all your data is the same. I have my four fields with headers, and my individual projects are still grouped together. To split those cells, click on the column header you want to split, not the entire table. From here, click the Split Rows under the Home tab and select By Delimiter. You could also find this option under the Transform tab or by right-clicking the header of your column. A new window appears. This is where you can set the rules of how the split will perform. You see how the delimiter is defaulted to space? Well, looking back at my data, we can see that my delimiter is a comma followed by a space.
It's important to include that extra space after the comma because that tells Power Query to split data into a new row at the start of the next text string.
To enter our delimiter, open the drop-down menu. You'll see a comma as an option, but that won't account for our extra space. Instead, choose Custom. A new text box opens below, and here's where you'll enter your comma and space. Go ahead and leave the split at section as it is. You want every instance of a comma and space to signify a new row. Open up the advanced options and change columns to rows. Everything else is fine, so we'll just hit OK. And there you go. You see how it not only split up that last column as we hoped, but it also repeated every other column to give us a complete data set to work with. We can also take this a step further and split our first column of contract manager names. To do that, repeat the steps of clicking the contract manager header, then select Split Column and By Delimiter. Here, you can leave everything set as it is. The delimiter is locked in as space, and under the advanced options, Power Query will split the names into two columns. Hit OK, and your table name has an additional column where first names and last names have been split.
Just make sure you rename the headers as necessary.
To do that, right-click on each header separately and select the Rename option. So for this table, I'll rename column A to first name and then change the column B to last name. When you're all done, head over to the Home tab and click on Close and Load. Your Power Query window will close and your original worksheet will have a new tab with your transformed data.
After one or two times of splitting your rows like this, you'll find it incredibly easy and you'll be able to split your cell into rows faster than you can say, "Why didn't I know that before?" Now, if you found that productivity hack easy, I've got two more for you that will speed up your workflow. And if you found this video helpful, go ahead and subscribe and show some love to that like button. Thanks for watching.